Hello everyone, thank you for joining me for this painting time-lapse where I'll show you the painting process of my latest painting called Mother's Hope and talk about the meaning behind this painting. I started this painting by applying a thin layer of acrylic paint for my underpainting to establish basic shapes and values. And then I proceeded with using the oil paints once the first layer was dry. I decided to paint Mary again, but this time in a completely different stage of her life. As a young mother of Jesus, Mary was told by Simon, a man of God filled with the Holy Spirit, that her son is the Messiah, but he will also have opposition in this world, and that there will be pain as well as joy. And Mary treasured all of these words in her heart. As years gone by, Mary saw Jesus grow into a man of God, full of wisdom and compassion. She wanted for him to finally be the Messiah he was created to be. She had high hopes for him, like all mothers do for their children. Mary urged him to use his powers to turn water into wine at the wedding in Cana, as she wanted him to step into his potential. The popular belief in that day was that Jesus was to be the king and that he would bring a political and economic change that would free people from their burdens. But God's plan was different. It didn't involve Jesus becoming crowned and coming to a political throne. It involved him wearing a crown of thorns and being crucified. From a human perspective, seeing Jesus on the cross didn't make any sense. He was supposed to be the savior of the world, not to be executed in such a manner. Even his disciples scattered, as they didn't understand why Jesus had to be crucified and were afraid that it was all over. But it was all part of God's good plan to save the world, to save each one of us, in the same manner as animal sacrifices were used in the ancient Israel times to atone for the sin of the people. Now Jesus, the perfect Lamb of God, was used to atone for the sins of the entire world. And I believe that Mary did have hope deep inside that somehow it is all going to turn out for good. That is why she came to the crucifixion site that day to look at Jesus. She was sad, but there was hope. Isn't that how all mothers are, always holding on to hope for their children, even in situations that others find hopeless? Mary did get to see Jesus again when he resurrected and appeared to her and all the disciples. But more important, that he was indeed who she said he was. He was indeed God. That is because to pay for the sins of all men, then that sacrifice is final. We don't need any other sacrifices. And we don't need to atone for our own sins in our own power anymore. We can't. But place the faith in Jesus, in our sins of redeeming, each one of us has to make. The Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life." John 3:16. And I believe that Mary, as any mother out there, had this hope, and she didn't know what is gonna happen, she didn't know how it is gonna turn out, but she just held on to hope, she just held on to God's promises that he's gonna use suffering for good of those who love him, and that it will all work out for good for his purpose. And on Mary's example, we can really see how God worked something that seemed like really bad situation into something so good. And I believe even now during our current situation that God is working our current situation for good, and something good will eventually come out of this. Even if we can't see it right now, even if we can't feel it right now, that God is using this current situation and he will bring glory to himself and he will accomplish his purposes through our current situation, and somehow it is all going to work out for good. So thank you for joining me for this painting time lapse. If you enjoyed the video, then give it a like and share it with your friends. And if you want to see more videos like this one, then subscribe to my channel.